गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग टू आवर लेक्चर वीडियो सीरीज इंट्रोडक्शन टू डीए कन्वर्टर्स. डीए कन्वर्टर्स आर बेसिकली यूज फॉर डिजिटल टू एनालॉग कन्वर्जन. इन प्रीवियसली वीडियोज वी स्टडीड अबाउट द वॉट इज डिजिटल टू एनालॉग कन्वर्टन, हाउ इज प्रोसेस गोइंग ऑन, वॉट आर द फंडामेंटल्स विच आर इफेक्टेड डीए कन्वर्टर्स. Then we are studying the types of DA converter, in which we are studying about R2R ladder network and voltage divider network. And now we are studying CMOS R2R DAC equivalent circuit. Here this is the circuit diagram which shown, and here this in this CMOS R2R equivalent circuit, R is the ladder resistance seen by the reference, and V reference by R is equals to full scale current output. So these are the parameters which is applied here, like RO, CO, codependent output resistance and capacitance, which are drawn in this circuit. The value of this R and the value of this RS and this CO. RFB is equals to DAC internal feedback resistor for use with external amplifier matched and tracking with R2R ladder network. And CFB is the compensation capacitance for CU, which is shown here. This is one, this one is CFB, this one is RFB. So the working of this type of DAC, in this the CMOS is applied here as a switch, and in this, when the device matching results are shown, it is very good in DC performance, and device scaling is difficult because R2R for high resolution, but typically higher power can't integrate digital signal processing. So in this type of DAC, when we applied input to these switches, these R2R ladder network give it the value for applying the signal and give it the DC signal. And here in the scaling issues, which can be simplified by this format, so means there is no need for R2R, and it allows integration of digital signal processing. So for the good device matching, there is 12 bit linearity calibration required for high resolution, and this device is very much popular in communication applications. Basically here our current sources are binarily weighted, that means to say when we applied here the digital data from these switch passes through, the analog data is coming out. So for the best AC performance, the multiplier is applied here, and I input and R load is coming, I input is coming through the R load. And for best DC performance, there is a feedback is applied in comparator, and it can compare with virtual ground. So these are the summary of these all DAC architectures. Like first we studied about resistance string. It has the inherent monotonicity. It is compact design, leading to the basis of multi-channel DAC, and it is difficult to get high performance INL. And R2R ladder, it have good DC performance, but it suffer from distributed RC effects and signal dependent loading in frequency domain application. It have multiplying capability, and it can operate in voltage mode for single supply application. Now for bipolar switched current DAC circuit, it suffers AC limitations because R2R is typically required to create LSB currents, and today we study as CMOS switched current. It is best choice for frequency domain application because it removes R2R, so there is no limit AC performance, good matching for DC specification, and it allows for integration with discrete signal processing blocks to ease implementation and improve performance. So here are the testing. These are the dynamic testing type where the clocks pulses are you clock pulse generator and digital data generator is applied, and these are the high performance spectrum analyzer where we can see the output data, and this is the static testing for DA converter where is the data processing and control circuitry are applied here. This is the DAC input code generator. This is the high resolution voltmeter and this is DC voltage reference. Thank you.